Hello everyone, I'm Brior and welcome back to Good Game Empire. If there's one topic every other Good Game Empire YouTuber has already covered that I have yet to get around to, there won't be one after today. In this video, I'll share my picks for the best things to spend rubies on in the game. Rubies are, of course, the premium currency in Empire, and it's important to know how best to spend them when you only have so many. I've picked out 8 items for this list, and you'll hear about the best of the best last. Without further ado, let's jump right in. Number 8, the Ruby Moat. The 8th item on our list is the Ruby Moat, which can be purchased from the Battlement screen for 12,500 rubies. Upgrading it, which becomes possible at Legendary level 250, costs 68,000 rubies. Having an upgraded moat goes hand in hand with having a powerful defense. While the formula used to calculate battles has never been released to players, I noticed a great improvement in my ability to defend and fire after I upgraded my moat there. The first ruby level is not prohibitively expensive, and I would recommend you upgrade your moat, at least in your main castle, when you have that many rubies to spare. When I combine my ruby moat with a solid castellan and armorer moat tools, I can get a bonus of 195%. Due to space limitations in the setup screen, attackers rarely send mantlets and moat tools on the same wave of attack, which means that an upgraded moat can be particularly potent. Number 7, the Marauder. The Marauder is a specialist that can be purchased from the King's Market. Most players already know that the Marauder will increase the amount of resources one loots, but less commonly understood is that he will also increase glory. This means that he's very helpful to have around whenever there's an event running you want to participate in. I don't know that I would recommend always having him around, but once again, if you know you'll be looting a lot over the course of the next week, I don't think you'll regret hiring him. It is cheaper to extend the Marauder than it is to purchase him outright. You'll get a prompt in your inbox when the Marauder is about to expire. When you invest your rubies and structures in your castle, you know you'll be getting a permanent and long-lasting bonus. While this doesn't mean that all structures are worth it, 4 of the remaining items on this list are indeed buildings. When upgrading permanent structures, you can often get a discount for doing multiple upgrades at the same time. Simply perform the first upgrade and then wait a few minutes to see if a special discount will appear. Number 6, the Hospital. The 6th item on our list is the first of the 4 ruby buildings that will make an appearance. The hospital is a place where you can heal your troops and recover some of your soldiers that would otherwise have been lost. Together with the barracks, it helps me maintain standing armies in green upwards of 10,000 soldiers. When you upgrade the military hospital, you will be increasing the amount of space you have for injured soldiers. A greater portion of the casualties you accrue in defense will survive uninjured. In some cases, you will also be granted an additional slot in the building with which to work. While I think you should invest in upgrading the building itself, I would caution against spending rubies to heal premium troops or to heal all troops at once. Ruby purchases made inside the building are ridiculously expensive and totally not worth it. Number 5, the Watchtower. The Watchtower is a building that will help you detect incoming attacks when they are far away. This building is a must-have for competitive level 70 players. Much of the PvP that is done at level 70 is dependent upon travel speed and early or late detection. Having an upgraded watchtower will allow your alliance members to get more support to you, and it will give you more time to set up your defenses for an incoming attack. An opponent might be discouraged from attacking you when he sees that you have a fully upgraded watchtower in your castle. You should also focus on conducting the early detection research and securing an early detection bonus on your castellan gear. It used to be that there were only 5 levels to the Watchtower, but the developer added 5 more levels, simply spreading out the already existing bonus to inflate this building's price. Number 4, Maps. Maps can be purchased for varying amounts of rubies from the Specialist tab within the King's Market. They increase the travel speed of your troops on the return journey, which will allow you to do a lot more looting. These maps are very cheap at first and become more expensive as you continue to buy them. They are permanent upgrades. Because they will allow one to do a lot more looting in the same amount of time, active players will pay off these maps really quickly, and I think the first few levels are a tremendous purchase. I will be interested to know what the maximum bonus you can get from maps is, so if anyone has theirs fully upgraded, please be sure to let me know in the comments. Number 3, the Bakery. The purpose of the bakery is to reduce the amount of food consumed by your troops, which can be very helpful for anyone who has massive hungry armies. Because the bakery works on a percentage basis, it's even more effective when you have a ton of troops. More troops will survive starvation when you have a bakery in your castle, and the building can also help you feed more troops overnight. The reason it's not higher up on this list is because it's now really expensive. The developers inflated its price in the same way they inflated the price of the watchtower, and I personally can no longer justify upgrading my bakeries to their maximum levels in all of my castles. Number 2. The Food Overseer. The penultimate item on our list is the Food Overseer, another specialist you can purchase from the King's Market. The Overseer increases the amount of food produced by your farmhouses and granaries by 25%, which is a truly tremendous amount for higher level players. The Overseer is cheap to buy and even cheaper to extend. At a cost of only 80 rubies per day, I'm quite certain that having the Overseer hired is a great deal. Whenever I go to extend the amount of time left on my Overseer, I normally put in a few months. Before we get to what is, in my opinion, the best ruby purchase in the game, here are some honorable mentions. Armorer defense tools are very important to have. In my opinion, you should never defend against another player's serious attack with anything less. However, you don't actually have to purchase these with rubies, because they can often be found at the mercenary post for coins. The drill instructor is a good purchase if you know you have a lot of recruiting to do. He can also help you to do better in recruiting-based nobility contests. There are two ways to increase the space of your market barrows with rubies. You can purchase an additional 7 right here from the King's Market itself, or you can conduct ruby research to get a bigger bonus. You can get big barrows without spending many rubies if you construct a marketplace build item. Number 1. Removing Gems. As you can see here, I have a completed and fully upgraded Kala's Mysteries Castellan set, and the unique gems seen here are amazing. If for some reason I wanted to defend with another Castellan set, I would only need to pay 495,000 rubies to put this gem back into my inventory for future use. It's amazing that more players don't know about this sweet deal. I'm just messing with you guys. The best ruby purchase in the game is actually a stables upgrade. I have upgraded my stables to level 3 in every castle because having faster moving armies helps me get a ton of additional looting done each and every week. In the same way that maps purchased from the King's Market will pay themselves off over time, so will the stables upgrades. Unlike the map upgrades, the stables upgrades will increase the travel speed of your troops both there and back, which means these upgrades are doubly worth it. It is crucial for level 70 players to have at least one fully upgraded stables from which to send PvP attacks. The faster your troops move, the less time the enemy will have to react to your attacks. If it only takes your attack 30 minutes to get there, there's no possible way that your opponent will detect it 40 minutes out. So there you have it, my thoughts as to what the best ruby purchases in the game are. If you think I missed something, or if you just plain disagree, please be sure to let me know in the comment section below. Many players have recently been asking me how they could best help me with my YouTube channel. I imagine that if you were to share this video with your alliance mates or just with your pen pals in Good Game Empire, that would do quite a bit for the channel. Thank you very much, I've been Brior, and I'll see you in the next video.